care to put that into EV mode, because we're going to do a bit of turn driving at some low speeds. And when we're in EV mode, the engine doesn't come on, and this shows the battery supplying power to the wheels. That's the screen that is going to give us the battery use, not using the engine. This shows the power flow out of the battery through the motor and driving the wheels. Okay, let's press pause and take a quick look at this screen display. The battery system monitor. The V out is showing 223, that's the voltage coming out of the battery system and going into the car battery. The amps coming out is 13.1. We'll see in a moment the scan gauge of the car battery. The scan gauge is showing us on the right column the BTV, the car battery voltage, is at 220. This is about 5 volts lower than the angina pack system is charging it, and the current coming out of the battery 27.4. Okay, so this is a typical drive through the town, through some back streets at 30 kilometers per hour. So we have enough power coming from our plug-in kit going to the hybrid traction battery. With this extra power, we can stay in EV mode much longer than we would have on driving on the traction battery alone without the plug-in kit.
Get up to 50, 49. It's going to go through the warm-up phase now, because you might as well go a bit faster. It's 70 road here. You're over 50, so... Normally if I'm going into town, I'll take the town route, because it's 50 max. Yeah, and then I can use pure electric. But here, once the warm-up phase is finished, you can use electric again. I'm still using quite a low amount, it's 3.9 litres.
Per 100 kilometre.
It's not too bad.
Okay, so after the engine has warmed up, which takes about a couple of minutes, you can then re-engage EV mode by removing your foot from the accelerator pedal and gently reapplying it.
You can engage electric. Oh, you have electric mode. Okay, that's interesting. 73. got the hang of this light foot thing then? Huh? Taking your foot off the gas and putting it on gently?
Yeah.
Quite easy.
Notice that after some mild acceleration you will slip out of EV mode. It takes a little bit of practice to keep the car in EV mode or do short bursts of acceleration to reach your desired speed. And then engage the accelerator lightly just to stay in EV mode. Okay, let's take a quick look at the fuel consumption monitor. It's quite low there in the last 5 minutes.
Yeah, going up little hills, you need a bit more power than you will with a light foot. So even a small hill, it will engage the engine and burn some gas. Then when we're on the flat, we should be able to cruise in electric mode. The trick is to pump the gas a bit, get up to the speed you want, and then light foot. Foot off again and re-engage. Then when we get into the city, I usually just click the EV button, get into electric mode. When you are completely parked or stopped, just to press the park, because that would do. That'll keep us in EV mode now. Which does allow us to accelerate a bit faster. Got a bit of gas there coming to
take. Does it just drive machen oder einfach nur das P wieder?
Drive.
Yeah. Ein P und dann drive.
No, just drive.
Okay.
the brake, you have to put your foot on the brake to get it into drive. So the battery is charging up nicely again now. And he has no idea where he's going. It does roll a bit after you put the brake on, I've noticed that, but it's okay, it doesn't roll far.
Here you can see the vehicle battery is taking 13.2 amps. This is coming out from the amps coming out of the kit, 14.4 coming out. So that's recharging the traction battery right now, while we're parked.
silent. Put the radio on. I can maybe dub out the sound anyway. So the engine's going into the warm-up cycle, which is okay actually, because we're going to come up to the auto about the fast bit, and you need the engine power actually.
I drive through the city.
Oh no, just here though.
I saw.
Just in this bit, you could probably go over 60. Over 50, so that's alright. So right now you see the engine is charging up the battery. Only because we're standing still, we're not actually going anywhere. You can't switch into EV mode. If you try to go into EV mode now, it won't let you because the engine's trying to warm up. Mm. Once that cycle has started, either after the first 8 seconds of driving or... if you go over 50, then it will start the engine. It's warmed up and it's switched off. Kind of cool. Now when you accelerate now, you won't have as much power with as you do in the EV mode, because the engine will come on. But it will also be easier for you to go... Oh, press the brake. Press the brake. Press the brake. There you go.
Sorry. Press the brake. I can't...
You can't change gear without it. Now the engine's warm, when we do want to get into this glide mode when we're above 50, it's now possible. You can't do that when the engine's not warm if you're in pure EV mode. But in blended mode, you can do it. It only takes about a minute to warm up the engine. Busy traffic, it is actually good, or on a road where you need to get moving, it's better to be in this mode because you can put your foot down and get the extra power. But yeah, as you done, you've gone back into electric mode and over 50. So now you can get up to any speed you want. Well, up to 70 anyway. And if you light foot the acceleration, you can even, yeah, you can take it up to 70 without the engine coming on. Okay, this is a 60 road here. Yeah, you're just running because of the hill. Cool. Pretty easy, you got the hang of it. So is it fun yet to get it into electric mode?
Oops. I don't know if I would say funny, but
fun.
Fun, yeah, it's great. And it is a different kind of driving a car. Only use benzene.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now you can decide how you drive.
Yeah.
What you use.
Yeah, that is. That's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
It takes a bit of getting used to, though, with the foot control to get to go automatically into the electric mode.
Mm-hmm.
But once you know how to do it, you do it when you have the chance. It's quite easy. Yeah, it won't slip into that mode above 70. Sometimes as well, if the engine does get cold, it won't let you go into the mode because it starts a little warm-up cycle again. I believe that's, from my experience, I think what's happening. Right now I'd probably hit EV mode just to keep into electric mode.
EV? Really?
Yeah. Because you're not going to go for 50 around here. Not bad. Kept the average down below 2.5. Pretty good for a city drive. Nice job.